afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your host, Elgin Martinez from the Immigrant Education Channel, the only channel that addresses real immigrant issues, coming to you with another informative video. But the video today, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be about the denaturalization office that was created under the Trump administration. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if you all are aware that once President Trump came into office, his administration created what is known as a denaturalization office to strip U.S. citizenship from people who they suspect committed fraud in attaining their citizenship. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, for many years, the Department of Justice focused its efforts to strip immigrants of their U.S. citizenship and also suspected war criminals who lied on their immigration paperwork. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, in February 2020, the Department of Justice announced the creation of a section dedicated to denaturalization. Furthermore, ladies and gentlemen, while the Office of Immigration Litigation already has received great success in the denaturalization cases it has brought, winning 95% of the time, the growing number of referrals from law enforcement motivated the creation of a standalone office dedicated to denaturalization. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, according to the New York Times, denaturalization has ramped up under the Trump administration. Ladies and gentlemen, of the 228 denaturalization cases that the department has filed since 2008, about 40% of them were filed since 2017, according to official department numbers. And over the past 3 years, denaturalization cases referrals to the department has increased over 600%. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, what is denaturalization? Ladies and gentlemen, denaturalization is the revocation of United States citizenship of a naturalized immigrant by the U.S. government. By law, ladies and gentlemen, denaturalization can only occur by a judicial order, either through civil proceedings or a criminal conviction for naturalization fraud. In addition, ladies and gentlemen, U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services refers cases for civil and criminal denaturalization to the Department of Justice when there is sufficient evidence that an individual is subject to one of the grounds of denaturalization. In addition, the Department of Justice, U.S. Attorney's Office, must then file revocation of naturalization action for civil denaturalization cases or criminal charges for criminal denaturalization cases in federal district court. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, a defendant can choose to voluntarily renounce their U.S. citizenship rather than contest the proceedings in court. That being said, an individual whose U.S. citizenship is revoked returns to the immigration status he or she had before becoming a U.S. citizen. Last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, the individuals may face deportation if he or she does not have lawful immigration status after they are denaturalized and or serve jail time if their U.S. citizenship was revoked because of a criminal conviction. That being said, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of this video. Please share, like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Last but not least, thanks to all my viewers and subscribers.